class, whatever you have started, we have just give same board I have maintained, only I make the ace is a green symbol. You look at that, and only in a grammar, there is when only one and only start symbol, no other. You might ask question why, but this is the practice in all kind of grammar, not only context-free grammar, only one start symbol. And the rules are numbered, and these are the AC start symbol here. The first of what we check, which variables are nullable. See, here we found it, AC is nullable, true, and A is nullable. If it is nullable, then we know the first of any nullable variable, and follow up that nullable variable, intersection, that is how many terminals comes in the first of X and how many terminals follow, there should be no common. It should be shy, intersection of this. So that is the case we have found it is the set of terminals, and remember this all it should be set of terminals. And epsilon can be there, dollar cannot be there in first, and dollar, that is end of input marker, can only come in the follow section of S, and any other variable it come, we will see. But it definitely come after S. Okay, so dollar cannot come in the first, epsilon cannot go to the follow, and we check which are the variables can go to epsilon. We can see the rule that by rule number 3, S goes to epsilon. So it is true. Then first we have calculated, and follow we have calculated, there is no common. So we know the for the LL1 grammar, the rule number 2, that is if non-terminal x can be derived epsilon, we will check whether first of x and follow of x should be psi. So it is quite satisfied. Now check for rule number 1, for each production a to sigma 1, that is the string, a to sigma 2 string, first of sigma I, intersection of first of sigma j, for all, inverted a means for all cases, I not equal to j, so that we check it here. For s, the first rule, the first of a, and for rule number 2, the first of b is equal to first of b is b, and if s to epsilon, first of is epsilon. So for s is okay. We can check subsequently for all other rules, this first condition is valid. So it is now fit case for top-down parsing, but to design parser, you have to create the parsing table. The parsing table is a, this is the parsing and this is the parsing table. Remember, this algorithm here will change for top-down parsing, bottom-up parsing, and also subsequently table will also change. This is LL1 parsing table that can be generated by the programmer, but it can be generally it's done by a program. For bottom-up parsing, your parsing table will change, and here also programming will change. So it's again a divide and conquer. Here you have the program, which is a table, lookup table basically. So here we use the lookup table. This is a parsing table, top-down table, and we have the row is the variables, start with S, and all the terminals, including epsilon, and we can find that, look at A's and A, which rule can be there, we can fit all the rules, 7 rules there, and remember, no box, there should be one and only rule. If the box can crack it, that is okay, but there can be one and, so that there will be no, so deterministic case. So if you can find here, and if you can find terminal there, there can be only one rule that can fire. That is the predictive parsing, deterministic predictive parsing, no backtracking, and it's a fit case for LL1. Let's try with this string, BCBA. So remember, whenever you top down parsing, we fill the tags. This is a dollar is end of stack markup. This dollar is different end of input markup, so they are different color. It is a black, it is a red, I mentioned. And in top-down parsing, you push first S, star symbol. We'll see in the bottom-up parsing, here in the end of top-down parsing, S will be taken out. And in bottom-up parsing, we'll start with a blank stack, and at end, S will come. So, totally reverse. Here we start from the star symbol and try to trace from the left-hand side, LL and bottom of side is LR. We start from the right hand side, we reach S. So definitely that S will come at the last, here S come at the beginning. And this is a string. Remember this string, whole string should not come to the stack. Remember, this is important point. So we should match with the top of the stack S and here with the LL1, leftmost is small b, and parsing table we can find the rule number 2 is fit enough. And so we take out S and the whole BAA comes here. Remember B should be at the top because it's a left to right. B should be top. Now S is taken away. This is a step number 2. This S is taken away. The S is taken away. This whole rule number 2 comes in. But your B should be there. You should not take out. When we take out B or any terminals, whenever any terminals match, top of the stack terminal match, then we can take out. Otherwise, you not. So here, now the top of the stack is B and your input is small b. What's the rule? This rule, rule number 2. Yes, so that you got it, then no. This b and small b, rule number 7. Mistaken. B to small b. So we replace this b with small b by rule number 7. Now, great. B and this b matches. So we take it out. Look at step number 4. I think it is visible. Step number 4 in the other board. Step number 4, because here B is taken away and here also pointer moves this way. So right now we have CBA and B is taken away. So we have capital A, small a. Now you have to match capital A with C. Capital A with C, we match the rule number 4, capital A to small c A. So we take the capital A and put CA there in step 5 in the stack. And then we found that C and this C matches, taken away. So now the step 6. And now we see that the top of the stack capital A. Yes, and your input is C is taken at B. B. Capital A and B, what's the rule? Capital A and B. Rule number 5, A to small b A. So we put, take out capital A, put B A. Now good thing B and this B matches. It's taken out. So see the step number 8. It is capital A, small a and capital A. We can use the rule number 6, that is A to epsilon. You take the A without consuming anything from input. That is that, okay. So right now, small a and your end of your screen is all, your input is A, so both taken out. So right now this empty stack and you have the input at the end. So this is the bottom, the top down parsing. So your stack start with S and should end with empty. Okay.